Joining us on the line is Bangko Sentral Deputy Governor Nestor Espinal. Good afternoon, Mr. Espinal. Thank you very much for joining us.
Hello, hi, Coco. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. So this order for the shift by between 2015 and 2017, why are we giving the banks so much time to do this? Why not, for example, within 1 or 2 years by 2015 instead of waiting till 2017, when these kinds of standards have been around for a while globally?
Yes, that's a fair question, Coco. Let me respond as follows. First of all, this two elements that you mentioned, the migration to an EMB chip card, as well as the migration of machines to a triple desk system, encryption system, are just but components of a broader reform process that the BSP is instituting, mainly to upgrade the way our banks and other BSP supervised institutions to manage their IT risks. Now, to your question, actually, first, on the matter of the triple desk machines, if we look at the situation right now, actually, many of the or most of the new machines that are being installed are already actually triple desk. Based on our estimate of the total ATM machines that are installed today, about 80% of them are actually already triple desk compliant to begin with. So there's only a smaller component that needs to make this migration by 2015. Now, on the matter of the chip card, the reason why we are allowing for a bit of time for this to happen is because there is a cost involved in the migration process. If you look at the world today, actually, although most of Asia would now have moved to chip-based card technology, major markets like the U.S. are still on magnetic stripe. In fact, I think their timetable is very similar to ours in terms of a migration to 2017. So it's a balancing of the cost versus the fraud risks that are potentially being mitigated. But let me also add that even today, we're already seeing a number of our big banks already moving to chip-based technology. And we expect, actually, the implementation to be much earlier than the deadline, or at least for many of the major banks locally.
I'm glad you mentioned the cost of the technology versus the fraud risk, or the risk of fraud here. Naturally or understandably, the banks don't really want to talk about how much fraud is going on, lest they reduce confidence in the system. How serious would you describe the fraud situation to be right now, Governor?
Yeah, you know, part of our consideration in terms of not moving sooner is that the fraud risk actually was not that high to begin with. However, the recent trends are also showing us that this level of risk is escalating. And part of that is the fact that since other markets are already more secure, then, of course, criminal elements tend to go to less defended markets, and we cannot afford to be behind that.
Okay. Deputy Governor Nestor Espinal, thank you very much for joining us this afternoon.